And on the eve of a tough budget, more job cuts. 100 Sydney ferry workers will be laid off as part of the government's privatisation plans.
With private operators lining up to take over Sydney Ferry's business, ferry services stopped for 5 hours today, leaving tourists and commuters stranded.
I'm hoping there's a map around somewhere that I can find out what bus to take now. But we're really looking forward to the ferry ride.
Ferry masters were briefed by their union on what to expect from privatisation. Deckhands were left high and dry when buses booked by Sydney Ferries to take them to a meeting failed to turn up. But it's back office workers, safety trainers and ferry controllers who will be hardest hit. 100 jobs will go when ferry runs are privatised.
We had meetings with Gladys prior to the election and after the election, and she clearly said that any worker who has the skills and wants a job will have a job. Well, these workers have the skills.
Transport Minister Gladys Berejiklian was in Cabinet but said in a statement she had a mandate to give customers a world-class ferry service.
With no guarantees their jobs will survive ferry privatisation, the union says these workers are expected to be made redundant next year.
It is a warning to everyone. Promises are expendable when they need to be, and I'm very worried about the state budget and the effect that will have not just on these 100 workers but on probably thousands of public sector workers.
Maritime union members say they want job guarantees extending beyond the 2 years they've been offered once ferries are privatised. John Hill, 10 News.